Hello, 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 everybody. This is the year 2020. As you can see, I've got a mask on my face because those are the regulations that have come into place now in the year 2020. It's a different year to many years that we have had. And not only is it a different year, but it is also the year when we are celebrating 60 years of the existence of the Anglican Students Federation. I am Reverend Mtebo Ayanza Given Sgudla, and I've been requested to just share my memories about the Anglican Students Federation in this its 60th year of celebration. As we will remember that the Anglican Students Federation was formed in the year 1960. And so it is actually older than all the countries in which it is represented. It is older than Lesotho. I think they got the independence in 1966, Eswatini in 1968. There's also Mozambique. I think they got their independence in 1975. And also we have Namibia, who got their independence almost at the same time as South Africa when apartheid was put aside. So ASF is actually older than the countries in which it exists. And this year we were supposed to have our 20th celebration, our 60th celebration here in the Kingdom of Eswatini. Unfortunately, because of the outbreak of coronavirus, which ended up making us walk around with masks on our faces and sanitizers on our hands and social distancing, we couldn't have this celebration. And we have now been requested to share with you what ASF has been to us. I remember very well in 1996 when I first came to the University of Cape Town to start my first year in engineering. I managed to look around. I found Anglican churches, and then at some point in time I eventually found the Anglican Society, which was in the church at St. Paul's in Rondebosch. And I've had an awesome and magnificent time with ASF, with NSOC, ever since. From that time, I have been with ASF from 1996 up until this year. My very first conference experience was in Mozambique in the year, I believe it was 1999, when I was doing my final year at in the university. Was it 1999 or 90? I think it was 1998 when I was doing my third year in university. I went off to Mozambique, and that was the very first time when I had a two-hour journey on the road, because the bus that we used for that year started off in Cape Town, went to Eastern Cape, went to Bloemfontein, went to Gauteng, collecting people all the way as we went, and we eventually got to Mpumalanga, and then we crossed the border. So we slept twice in the bus as it was traveling, and we really had a great time of bonding and meeting. And we went to the Mozambique in Maputo. We went to, I believe it was the Frelimo Conference Center where we went, and we had a great time. We met people, we saw people. All along, I hadn't been able to go to ASF conferences because they always came during the middle of the year when I had internships and other things to do. So the one year that I managed to make it, I went to Mozambique. And the year after that was 2000, when we then came to Eswatini and we celebrated 40 years of existence of ASF, when we had a great time at Luyemo where we had the conference. So I've attended the conference. After that, I went to Lesotho. I think I've attended the conference twice or thrice in Lesotho, and then I've attended the conference twice in Eswatini, I've attended the conference twice in Mozambique, I've attended the conference once in the Western Cape, I've attended the conference probably once or twice in the Eastern Cape, I've attended the conference at least three times in KZN, I've attended the conference once in Gauteng, Mpumalanga. Unfortunately, I haven't been able to attend the one in Angola, the one in Limpopo, as well as the one that took place in Namibia. I'm hoping that in my time, I will continue to find time to be able to go and attend those conferences.
In ASF, I started off with at NSOC. I was just a member. Then I became the Media and Publications Officer of the UCT NSOC. Then I became co-chairperson of the UCT NSOC. Then I became Western Cape chair of the Western Cape region. And from being chairperson of the Western Cape region, I became president of the Federation for the whole Southern African region. And then it stopped there. I came back. I completed my studies. I came to work. When I started working, at some point in time, I was a lay minister, so I used to assist in services of ASF until I eventually came to a point when I was ordained in 2011. And then after ordination, I started assisting the chaplain of Eswatini by looking after the NSOCs that were in the Mbabane site, which was Mbabane campus as well as a Scott campus. And having done that, at some point in time, I then eventually became provincial chaplain of the Anglican Students Federation. And after being provincial chaplain, I have now also been appointed to be chaplain here in Eswatini. Over and above being an assisting priest in the cathedral, I am also assisting in terms of running the NSOCs in Eswatini. So NSOC ASF I've been there for many years. I have seen things happening. I have many memories. I remember at UCT, the very first publication from NSOC, UCT, we called it Ansorazi, and I was one of the editors, and I worked very hard to get that moving. I remember the time when ASF started having problems, financial problems, when we were being told that the province would start cutting money that was given to ASF. And we started with the chaplain of the time, Father Richard Shorten, when I was still president in 2000. In 2001, we started a shop which we called Bell Smells and Bells, which used to stock a whole lot of items, and we were able to make a little bit of money. Babe Richard used to donate from himself on his trips, traveling around. He would pick up all the interesting things, put them in the shop so that people could buy, and would try to make money for ASF. During the time I was president, I remember we had our organizer who had been there for a little while passing away, and we were all worried what was going to happen to the Federation. But God, being a wonderful God, enabled us to move forward. We were able to hire a new organizer, and later on we also lost our secretary, our administrative secretary, who went to work in the Diocese of Cape Town. And then we managed to hire a new the administrative secretary. So it was quite a busy time during the time when I was there. There were quite a number of changes. We started looking at how to run our meetings more efficiently. We started looking at things like how to make our chabula more Christian, because I remember when I first got to ASF, the chabula that I found there was very, very astonishing for me as a Christian who was from a very traditional background, a conservative background. So, but we are happy that we have seen the Federation grow in many, many, many ways. We have seen leaders come out of the Federation. We've had leaders who came before us. For instance, our Archbishop, we've had a number of bishops who have been in the Federation. We really had a great time. We've seen others who have gone on to become chaplains, who have gone on to become archdeacons, who have gone on to become canons, who all came through from the Federation. And I know for a fact that the Federation has played a big part in me finding my vocation as a priest in the Church of God. I am here now coming live to you from the Cathedral Church, where I assist the dean in ministering in the cathedral, and also in the various the branches that the cathedral has around the city of Mbabane. ASF has really played a great role in forming my ministry, in assisting me to discover my ministry, and I believe many others would also have the same to say to you. We are very, very grateful and happy to God for having kept the Federation to this time when we are celebrating 60 years. It's been a long time. And we believe we still have many years ahead of us for us to be able to work. And we are happy to see that the Federation is transforming and trying to find itself relevant to the needs, especially the spiritual needs of the students. We know we still have our own delinquents, as we did during our time. There were those who were delinquent, but we are happy that at some point in time, God touched their lives and they were able to be changed and transformed. So even those who are delinquent during our during this time, as we celebrate the 60th anniversary, we say, may the Almighty God open their eyes so that they will really understand what it is to be a Christian, what it is to be an Anglican and an Anglican student, so that wherever we are, we become ambassadors of Christ. We hope that as we do the various things that we will be doing to celebrate the 60th anniversary of the Anglican Students Federation, we will really look back and see the power of God at work in the church, the power of God in building us up, in transforming us, and helping us in ministering to the students, because many students get lost to the church when they get to varsity. ASF has provided a home away from home that has enabled us to keep so many people and prevent them from straying and going away from God when they get to varsity and they get so much freedom. The churches, the NSOCs that they have found themselves to have assisted them to continue worshiping God and discovering themselves in God. I hope that we are going to see many, many more years of ASF, and we are going to see my greatest hope is that the province is going to take a different financial stance towards ASF and the youth ministry as a whole. We know the province, because of financial constraints, has cut the funding, but believe you me, when you invest in ASF, you are investing in the church for today and the church for tomorrow. And if you fail to invest in ASF, you are making the church for tomorrow to also have failure. And you will see the church failing and falling and wonder what has happened, only to realize that it is because the church started losing focus and losing enthusiasm on building up ASF and pushing up ASF to be what it has always been and to become even better in what it is. Wishing you a happy 2020, and we hope that in 2021, we are going to meet again as ASFers and have a great time as we sing and praise. We have all those songs that we remember, the Mozambicans teaching us Vamyaya, Vamyaya, Vamyaya. And you know, we've been to so many different places. We've seen so many different places. Some of the trips have been wonderful. I remember the last trip that we took as Eswatini, where we went to Western Cape. We had a fantastic time for those who took the drive all the way from here to there. We had such great and wonderful memories. Even when we had the time there, even the time we drove down to Northwest, we had a great time traveling there, and we had a great time also meeting other ASFers. We hope that ASF will continue to grow. We hope that ASF will continue to be relevant. May the Almighty God bless ASF, help ASF to grow, help ASF to be what it is. Happy 2020 and happy 60th anniversary, ASF, in as much as we are still sanitizing and putting on masks. We hope that we are all going to survive the COVID virus. May you take good care of yourselves and make sure that we get to the following year to celebrate together another anniversary of ASF. Thank you very much. God bless you. Amen.